previous videos, you have learned about what fonts of knowledge is and why it is important. But how do you actually apply it to your classroom or program? When using a fonts of knowledge approach, first and foremost, it is important to have a shift of mindset. That means moving away from thinking of your youth as empty vessels to instead highlighting the assets and knowledge they bring with them to any learning experience. Viewing youth as holders of important knowledge and encouraging them to share that knowledge, skills, and practices in the classroom is key to embracing fonts of knowledge. Another thing educators can do is to establish a culture that provides a safe learning environment based on mutual respect and understanding. This welcoming classroom or program environment encourages youth to actively participate and acknowledge that their comments and contributions are meaningful. Educators create this classroom culture by establishing confianza and rapport with youth and their families. A great place for educators to start creating bridges between fonts of knowledge and STEM is by discovering what knowledge youth bring to the classroom or program. Once this knowledge is discovered, value it. Value it as important in your conversations about STEM. Finally, ask youth to apply that knowledge while participating in STEM activities. For example, we collaborated with a bilingual teacher who wanted to integrate fonts of knowledge into her lesson about recycling. First, she asked her students to do a community walk to identify the ways in which their community already engaged in recycling practices, such as identifying the different numbers or colors used for recycling bins and asking their family members about how recycling can be done at home. Since most of the students were transnationals, they talked about how recycling and collection of discarded items was done in both Mexico and the US. Then the teacher used the students' reflection to design her unit and help students identify the characteristics of materials that can be reduced, recycled, and reused. This process helped the teacher become more conscious of how the curriculum centered on concepts that did not reflect the lived realities of her students. For example, the unit previously focused on fast fashion, but through the community walks, the teacher learned that most of the families actually made their own clothes. Therefore, the teacher could tailor her lesson to recycling concepts that held more meaning for her students. A fonts of knowledge approach can be beneficial for both educators and youth. It helps create an environment where learning is an ongoing process for everyone. You can make small changes to the content you're already using so you can learn more from youth, such as doing community walks, using surveys, or asking youth to share experiences from home or the community. Additionally, it is important to be willing to share your own fonts of knowledge and to take the time to listen to their experiences. This approach and openness will foster an environment where everyone can bring their whole selves to the classroom or program. This work is best undertaken by embracing the ambiguity that comes with exploring new ways of being, knowing, and doing. You don't have to know it all, and you get the chance to learn from the youth you work with. This process requires constant self-reflection, commitment, and trust building. It is good practice to engage in self-reflection, to think of ways you, as the educator, can be more attuned to the lives of the youth and to process your conceptions about the populations you work with. Commit to learning. This process will be ever evolving because culture, knowledge, and communities are not static. Lastly, continue to build that confianza or trust with the youth, families, and community you work with.